Today we'll discuss the notes on functional matrix concept. So whenever you have been asked about any hypothesis, theory or whatever, so it's better that you mention the name of scientist, okay? So that will put a good impression on examiner and get good marks. And then write about the introduction, give some insight into the answer. So basically this functional matrix concept, it talks about the form and function, right? It tells us about the form and function. You'll understand that when we see examples and discuss further. So a number of functions, these are carried out in the craniofacial region, like respiration, mastication, hearing. So many things are involved in this, okay? So like mastication, it is not alone brought about by teeth. Alveolar bone, teeth, muscles of mastication, occlusion, they all together work and carry out the process of mastication. Okay, so these functions are carried out by the functional cranial component that we call. So this functional cranial component, it includes the tissues, organs, spaces and skeletal parts to carry out this function, like respiration, hearing, speech. Okay, so this functional cranial component, it has in tissues, organs, spaces and skeletal parts. So now we divide this functional cranial component into functional matrix and skeletal units. So the functional matrix, it includes tissues, organs and spaces, okay? And the skeletal units, it contains the bones, cartilage and tendinous tissue. So we first see the functional matrix. What is included in the functional matrix is, there's this periosteal matrix and capsular matrix. These both come under functional matrix. So the periosteal matrix, it has muscles, blood, teeth, blood vessels, teeth, nerves and glands. Okay, so these periosteal matrix, these things, they act directly and actively on the skeletal unit to perform a particular function. And these things, they actively and directly cause changes or deformation in the skeletal units. We'll see how when we move on with the video. Now the capsular matrix. So there are two capsules we're going to talk about, the neurocranial and orofacial capsules. So the neurocranial, it includes the skin, connective tissue, base of skull, aponeurosis, periosteum and two layers of dura mater. So this periosteal matrix, it influences the microskeletal units. And this capsular matrix, it influences the macroskeletal units. So that was about the functional matrix, divided into periosteal matrix, capsular matrix, okay. So now we see the skeletal unit. So it comprises the microskeletal unit, macroskeletal unit. So when we talk about microskeletal unit, we have mandible and maxilla. So these are the microskeletal units that constitute one macroskeletal unit. The alveolar bone, coronoid, condyle, mental, gonial, these all form one macroskeletal unit, that is mandible. They work in coordination all together to form one unit, okay? So likewise in maxilla, it is formed by the orbital, pneumatic, palatal and basal bone. So these are the microskeletal units that make up a macroskeletal unit, that is maxilla. Let's understand this theory in detail. So like I said, periosteal matrix, it includes the blood vessels, nerves, organs, glands, okay? So they act on skeletal unit. So they act directly and actively upon the skeletal units, mainly microskeletal units. And thus, they alter shape and size of the skeletal units. They bring about transformation of skeletal units, okay? So it's not like moving the skeletal units. No, they are bringing transformation. And transformation by bone deposition and resorption. So these periosteal constituents that we talked about, like glands, organs, blood vessels and nerves, so they act directly on the skeletal units and they cause transformation of that bone, of that skeletal unit. Let's see how. Now you see here, this is the mandible, and when the teeth are present, we have already talked about this in the one of my video with the title Development of Occlusion. So I suggest you once check it out so you will understand the concepts much better. Okay, so you see alveolar bone deposition takes place when the teeth start to erupt. When the teeth are present, the deposition occurs. And when no teeth are present, resorption occurs. So you see teeth is a component of this periosteal matrix. Okay, so it's a periosteal unit. And alveolar bone is a microskeletal unit. So you see how the microskeletal unit is influenced by a periosteal unit. And when there are no teeth present, the resorption of the alveolar ridges occur. we periodically realign the denture, complete denture patients, we do periodically relining because there's this resorption going on in those. So again, one more component we'll see, that is blood supply, blood vessels, that is one of a constituent of periosteal matrix. So when there's a good blood supply to a particular bone, so bone is healthy and there's deposition going on. But if there is no blood supply due to disease or anemia, or say due to age, so there's this no blood supply or limited blood supply, then the resorption of bone occurs. Again, blood vessels, these are part of periosteal unit, okay, that influences the microskeletal unit. So you understand how the periosteal constituents, these are changing or causing transformation of skeletal units. We move on to the next, that is capsular matrix. Now this acts indirectly and passively on the macroskeletal units. So the constituents of this capsular matrix are neurocranial and orofacial capsule. Okay, so this acts indirectly and passively on skeletal units, like how the expansion of this capsule takes place. There's this neurocapsule around brain and all. Okay, so that expansion of this occurs, it causes the forward and downward translation of movement of maxilla and mandible. Again, we talked about this in the development of occlusion, how the mandible grows forward and downward. So it acts indirectly and passively. So it brings about the translation of skeletal units, and there is alteration in the position of skeletal unit. In the periosteal matrix, there was just transformation of the skeletal unit. Here there is translation of the bone or skeletal units taking place. So the translative motion is not produced by bone deposition and resorption here, unlike the periosteal matrix. So that was it, guys, about the functional matrix theory. Please let me know in the comment section below if you like this note teaching, or if you want me to switch to that PPT teaching. Please let me know in the comment section below. Let me know your opinion. So yeah, thank you. I hope that helps.